Music in the year 2021 is coming to an end, and you already know I had to share my list of the best albums this year had to offer. A lot of fairly unknown artists made it this year, with the more known names in music not having the best year or not releasing any material at all. This is a top 25 list, and my personal one at that, so there will be major differences between mine and yours. Hopefully by the time you're finished watching, you'll be able to see an album that's on your list as well. I'm always interested in seeing others' taste in music, so don't be afraid to share your favorite albums in the comments. I don't want to take up too much of your time, so let's start with number 25, Cool Dry Place by Katie Kirby. Starting off the list strong with Texas-born, Nashville-based Katie Kirby. Reminiscent of Waxahachie, she's fairly new to the music world. With just a few standalone tracks and Cool Dry Place, she's already proven herself as someone to look out for. The indie artist has received loads of positive feedback for this record. Publications such as Stereo Gum, Pitchfork, Album of the Year, and more. You should definitely tap into Katie Kirby and her work. Highlights include Traffic, Portals, and title track, Cool Dry Place. Number 24. Sometimes I Might Be Introvert by Little Sims. The best way for me to explain Sometimes I Might Be Introvert is that it's like a movie or like a cinematic experience. The intro to the album, Introvert, truly feels like the opening to an open-world dystopian universe. Throughout the tape, Sims has given us clever, slick bars and giving introspection, which is something she's very keen on. The British rapper made a splash with her 2019 album, Grey Area, and has come back again in a big way with the top 25 album of the year. Favorite tracks are Introvert, Standing Ovation, Woman, and I Love You, I Hate You. Number 23, Letter Blue by Wet. New York-based group Wet simply makes amazing music. This is a group that I've yet to see miss. Letter Blue strays away just a little from what they typically offer, with this album being stripped down and more minimal than usual. The one thing that keeps this album going in such a great direction is the vocals from frontwoman Kelly Zutrow, complemented with her writing as well. Highlights include On Your Side, Clementine, and Larabar. Number 22, And Then Life Was Beautiful, by Now. Out of all the artists I'll be showing in this video, Now is by far the most unique. Think of soul music, but nods to funk and pop it all wrapped in one. She's been consistently putting out amazing projects, with And Then Life Was Beautiful being my favorite. Songs that stuck with me the most are Messy Love, Wait, and Antidote. Number 21, Life in Your Glass World by Citizen. Citizen is an alternative rock group hailing from the Midwest. If you know anything about the Midwest and their music scene, is that it's often emo-driven with a somber guitar riff to kick off a song. With bands and groups sounding similar in the space, Citizen has been able to cultivate a strong following and separate themselves over the years. They've been able to switch up their sound just enough to stay relevant as well. Life in Your Glass World is a testament to just that. If you're familiar with Turnover, Movements, or even Tiger's Jaw, which is really good by the way, they just missed my list this year, you'll have a good time with this record from Citizen. Highlights include Black and Red, I Want to Kill You, Call Your Bluff, and Blue Sunday. Number 20, Blue Weekend by Wolf Alice. I wasn't fond of Wolf Alice only until a couple years ago, and I've been pleasantly surprised on the material that they've been able to produce. They can tap into funk, traditional rock, and even subtle hints of pop. Blue Weekend was an overall great project. Favorite tracks include The Last Man on Earth, Smile, Feeling Myself, and The Beach. Number 19, Different Kinds of Light by Jade Bird. Jade Bird, indie alternative rock artist from London, is probably the most slept on artist I've ever known about. I literally never hear or see people talk about her work. Different Kinds of Light is powerful, spunky, and heartfelt. A complete body of work that will not disappoint. My go-tos are Punchline, Honeymoon, Trick Mirror, and the title track, Different Kinds of Light. Number 18, Up to Me by Yeet. Best New Artist Award goes to Yeet. He seemed to come out of nowhere, but has been putting in the work to reach to the point he's at now. Up to Me is a huge statement project with 22 songs and nonstop energy. The ones that go a little too hard are Money So Big, Ya Ya, Can't Change, Told Ya, Rockstar, and Get Busy. Number 17, The Fool by Blade. Sweden rapper, model, and creative Blade is somewhat of an originator or trendsetter. Him along with frequent collaborators Echo 2K, Tyboy Digital, and Young Lean cultivated a lot of the sounds you hear in modern American trap today. Travis Scott, Quavo, and even Frank Ocean have all been inspired or worked with the small collective out of Sweden. On The Fool, Blade showcases his actual rapping ability, which has been swept under the rug in the past. With him bringing that to the forefront, and him always having amazing production, this project is almost a no-skip. My favorite songs are Ego Baby, Trendy, Baby, Hotel Breakfast, and I Think. Number 16, Home Video by Lucy Dacus. Home Video definitely crept up on me, and was really nowhere on the radar for my top 25 list. But something told me to revisit this project, and after running it back, I felt dumb afterwards. Like, how could I be so asleep on this tape? If you've become a fan of Phoebe Bridgers in recent years, you will absolutely need to take a listen to Lucy and Home Video. Here's the ones I go back to the most. VBS, Hot and Heavy, Thumbs, and Partner in Crime. Number 15. Lately I Feel Everything by Willow. Man, what a 2021 for Willow. She absolutely took over with songs like Transparent Soul and Meet Me at Our Spot, both doing very well in the charts. This punk rock influenced album is nothing short of great. Drummer Travis Barker being featured and having multiple writing credits is another reason why this project shines so bright. Favorite tracks are Glow, Lipstick, Naive, and Come Home. Number 14, Sour by Olivia Rodrigo. After Driver's License was listened to what seemed to be every person on earth, Olivia had a smooth transition into her album rollout by releasing a few singles in a timely manner and not sticking to one sound. With her doing that, you already know that she has different vibes to offer. I loved how she kept the album short with just 11 songs that are filled with blissful backing vocals and experimental production. She has a promising career. The ones that I go back to the most are Traitor, Favorite Crime, and Good For You. Number 13, 4L by Yeet. Yup, another Yeet album. You might as well call this year the Yeet year. Rather than keeping the foot on the gas all the way through like Up To Me, he takes the much needed breaks with tracks like For Really, Bedside, and Trying To Tell You. With the hip-hop slash trap scene being so crowded, he's done a good job of making his voice unique and stand out from the rest. But his beat selection is probably his best attribute. 4L is a tape that's been in rotation for a while. Some of my favorite tracks are Bedside, Just Woke Up, For Really, Off The Lot, Sideways, and OK Cool. Number 12, Soulfly by Rod Wave. Rod Wave is super consistent and is one of the best rappers right now. With Soulfly, and more specifically Soulfly Deluxe, a lot of the songs do sound similar, but the production, mixing, and mastering of each is just that good. Street Runner, Tombstone, Losing My Cool, and Richer are the ones I go back to the most. Number 11, Alpha by Charlotte Day Wilson. Out of Toronto, Ontario, she's bound to be successful. I promise, Canada, and more specifically Toronto, has the best music. R&B to the core is what she's bringing to the table on Alpha. Really in a lane of her own. Favorite songs are If I Could, Keep Moving, and Mountains. Number 10, Jubilee by Japanese Breakfast. Another consistent artist that doesn't rush into any material she releases. Jubilee is a bit heavier on the ear, with the production being the forefront rather than her amazing vocals that we're used to. But that doesn't stop her from showcasing her ability to fit in perfectly. Bangers from the album are Paprika, Poison and Bondage, Be Sweet, and Slide Tackle. Number 9, Any Shape You Take by Indigo D'Souza. Hailing from North Carolina, Indigo has got a lovely voice that demands your attention. She's currently 2 for 2 with her albums. Hold You is a slapper, 17, Pretty Pictures, and Die Cry are great as well. Number 8, Hotels by Jasmine Sullivan. There was a point in time where I legit forgot about Jasmine Sullivan. She's like the Frank Ocean as far as showing up and then disappearing for a couple years. Hotels is as cohesive as an album can get. There are multiple tales or stories being told throughout its runtime, which allows you to immerse yourself in each song even more. Here are my top songs from the album: On It, Lost One, and Pick Up Your Feelings. Number 7, Donda by Kanye West. What an album. I'm a pretty big fan of Kanye because he's always bringing something new, always. And his material sonically is just better than a lot of artists. Donda has a similar formula to his last few albums, but is concentrated on one thing, which is Donda. This is the perfect blend of old Ye and new Ye. Highlights are Off the Grid, which is a potential song of the year, by the way, Come to Life, Believe What I Say, Moon, Jail, and Hurricane. Number 6, I Don't Live Here Anymore by The War on Drugs. The War on Drugs is one of those groups that you can't not listen to. Think of a coming-of-age movie or 90s teen drama. That's The War on Drugs. Guitar-driven with a lot of empty space. I Don't Live Here Anymore is my favorite album from the group. Some of my faves are Change and the title track, I Don't Live Here Anymore. Number 5. An Evening with Silk Sonic by Silk Sonic. I was shocked when I saw Anderson .Paak and Bruno Mars collaborating. Although shocked, I knew whatever they were producing would be amazing. Think of 70s R&B and soul with a modern day sound. The standouts are 777, Skate, and Smoking Out the Window. Number 4. Project X by Ken Carson. This is crazy nice. Ken Carson is only second to who I believe had the biggest year, and we all know who number 1 is, Yeet. Project X leads with bouncy production, tasteful synths, and catchy flows. No skip project. Ones I listen to the most are Who's Next, Burning Up, Till I Die, and So What. Number 3. Valentine by Snail Mail. Alternative rock's finest came back with some heat in Valentine. Lindsey Jordan sounds better than ever, production was turned up a bit, and her songwriting has elevated to a very high level. Ones I'm spending the most are Madonna, Ben Franklin, and Letter Blue. Number 2. 30 by Adele. Fire, fire, fire. If Adele is dropping that year, don't even listen to the album. Just place it in your best album list and carry on with the rest of your day. 30, she let out all of her emotions and had been the most transparent since we've known the artist. The best songs are To Be Loved, I Drink Wine, My Little Love, and Easy On Me. And the album of the year goes to Glow On by Turnstile. If you want an album to get you absolutely hype, and in your feels, all while floating through space, you're in the right place. This is the one. This hardcore group has garnered a major following after the release of Glow On. I'm also glad I'm not the only one that thinks this high of the record. Many review sites and blogs have had this in their top 10, so you know it's been widely chosen as a top 10, top 25 album of the year. Here are the tracks that I cannot stop listening to. All of them. I mean, it's that good. And that's a wrap. That's my top 25 albums of the year. It was fun compiling all of these projects into one video and seeing them side by side after listening to so much music. It was definitely a cool experience. But if you love music and discovering different sounds, consider sharing this video. I feel this is a great introduction to what my channel is about. We love music over on this side. It's all about getting out your comfort zone and breaking the mold. So with that being said, thank you for watching. Merry Christmas and happy holidays to all of you around the world. I'll catch you in the next one.